Hello everybody. Let's see the next problem in which we have been finding out the Fourier series coefficients x of k. Understand? Now compared to the previous problem, in the previous problems or the problems that we have seen so far, the equations used to be given. X of t used to be given in terms of equation. Now the same x of t is given in terms of the waveform. Okay, the advantage here is they have very clearly said that this waveform what we have is sine pi t. This is a time domain signal. X of t is a time domain signal. That's why this is t. The x-axis is t. And this sine pi t has to be a periodic signal because Fourier series are applicable to the continuous time periodic signals. Understand? So this is periodic. So what is one period here needs to be understood first. Before we go for obtaining the coefficients, we need to get this information from this particular waveform. Now this is one, but after this, the same pattern is not repeating. Get this, after this 1 second, the same pattern is not, that means 0 to 1, this is not one period. So let's say 0 to 2. See, from 0 to 2, if you take, from 2 onward, the same pattern is repeating again. The same pattern is repeating again after every 2 seconds. That means this 2, this much, is actually one period. Okay, so t is equal to 2 seconds. If t is equal to 2 seconds, what is angular frequency omega? I've told you the angular frequency, or let's say, for all continuous time periodic signals, okay, the fundamental period is t equal to 2 pi by omega naught seconds. If t is equal to 2 pi by omega naught seconds, it means that omega naught, the angular frequency is 2 pi by t, the fundamental period. Okay, that is what is the information we can extract, and that looks like this. So this is my observation. T is equal to 2 seconds, the units have not come there, but when you are noting, see that you write the units, it's 2 seconds. Okay, and here 5 radians per second. Understand this? Now what we can do is we can directly take x of k. The equation is x of k because we are asked to find out the Fourier series coefficients. Here we're not doing the problem by expressing this sine pi t in terms of complex. No, we're not doing it that way. We are trying to extract the coefficients by considering the equation for the coefficients in frequency domain. This is the analysis equation. So substitute t as 2 and take the period over which you are integrating as 0 to 2. Okay, and substitute sine pi t in place of x of t, and that looks like this. And what they have done, this sine pi t is expressed in terms of, they've expressed this in terms of what? The complex exponentials. Here, sine pi t is expressed in terms of complex exponentials, which is e power j pi t minus e power minus j pi t by 2j. Now, just try have the two terms on which we are integrating, right? So this 2j is a constant, bring it out. So outside it would become, along with this 1 by 2, it would become 1 by 4j, okay? And integrate this exponential along with this with respect to dt. Similarly, integrate this second exponential along with this exponential with respect to dt. This is how it is going to look like. Fine. Now, if you integrate an exponential, how is it going to look like? So, if you integrate this, it is the same term, okay, divided by j into 1 minus k into pi, leaving this t in the denominator. Similarly, this, and apply the limits. Fine. If you apply the limits, this is how it is going to look like. Once you apply limit 1, so in the numerator you'll have only this exponential leaving t, and next is again apply t equal to 0. Okay, so this looks like this. This is 1. Similarly here, e power 0 is the second time you get when you apply 0 as the limit. So limit 1 applied minus limit 0 applied. Limit 1 applied minus limit 0 applied. Anyways, in the denominator, there is no t, so the denominator would remain the same. Understand that? Now, if you just go on doing that, okay, you will get your x of k to be this. Understand this point? Okay, and where did this k vanish? Where did this k vanish? See, this they have done by going with LCM, and when you take LCM, it would become j into j, and j square is minus 1. Okay, so that is how they have got rid of j here. So j term is missing here because of this operation, multiplication operation after taking the LCM. Is that okay with you? You can just see how it goes on. This is a simple stuff. You will be able to get this. Okay, so if you want the coefficients x of 1, x of 2, x of 3, you just have to go on giving the what numbers. Okay, the different frequency components of your coefficient. This is a generalized equation. So if you want the frequency components, you need to go on giving the frequencies 1 hertz, 2 hertz in place of k, and obtain the spectrum if you want. And since the spectrum was not asked, maybe we'll not go with drawing the spectrum for this magnitude spectrum or phase spectrum. But you should be able to get the equation for x of k. If you are asked to plot the magnitude or phase spectra, then you have to go on substituting the values here. 1 minus 1, 2 minus 2, k equal to 0. If you substitute, what happens? So all that you need to do. Let's go on to the next problem. Another waveform is given. So this also has to be a periodic waveform since we are finding out the Fourier series coefficients. Fine. Now, what is the period of this? Okay, and once you find out the period, what is going to be the angular frequency for this? So those two things we need to understand. Now, from where to where we can consider? We can consider it from anywhere. See here, if we start here, let's say, if we start here, if we come till this. From 0 to 6, it is one period. Because after that, again, the same thing will repeat from 0 to 6. Okay, instead of saying that, you can say minus 3 to 3. Some people can say minus 3 to 6. Why you want me to go from 0 to 6? I'll go from minus 3 to 3. Absolutely no problem. You should be getting the same coefficients at the end. Understand? So what is the idea is, consider one period over which you have to apply the integration. Understand that? So that is what we're doing now. So by observation, t is equal to 6 seconds. The fundamental period is 6. Start from 3, go till plus minus, start at minus 3, go till plus 3. Understand this? Okay? Or start at 0, go till plus 6. Fine. So let's see how they do it. Okay, this is the equation for finding out the coefficients. So whenever the waveforms are given, we find out the fundamental period and the angular frequency and go with this equation for coefficients. That is the synthesis, that is the analysis equation. Understand? So just substitute it's as 1, t as 6, and take the period from period as minus 3 to 3, the integration from which we are applying. Okay, take that integration range over minus 3 to plus 3. Understand? Now, see here. So this is what it is. Fine, we will come to that. What they are doing, just have to substitute x of t. What is x of t now? That needs to be told. This is very important. See here, x of t is here, and x of t has values 0 from minus 3 to plus 3 in some places. From minus 3 to plus 3, it has got 0 in some places. Okay, so it is 0 from minus 3 to minus 2. It is 1 from minus 2 to minus 1. And it is minus 1 from 1 to 2. So except this minus 2 to minus 1 and 1 to 2, rest all the signals are zero signals. So what I do, I split this into two terms, two integral terms. One is from minus 2 to minus 1, we have x of t, and that x of t is 1. So from minus 2 to minus 1, it is 1. From 1 to 2, it is minus 1. That is what is written here. From minus 2 to minus 1, it is 1. From 1 to 2, it is minus 1. This minus has come here. Everybody understand that point? Okay. Now, after that, you just integrate. Integration exponential is quite simple. Okay. Apply the limits carefully. Right. After applying the limit, this is what we are going to get. This is what we are going to get. Okay. The steps I've shown in the next page. This is something that I have worked out. Right. What is done here? So you just apply the limits. Once the limit would come as minus 1, then the next limit would come as minus 2. And in the denominator, we don't have t. So this you can take out. The denominators can be taken out and then apply limits to this. So what would be this with limit minus 1? So it would be e power jk pi by 3. The first term. The second term is minus with the limit minus 2 applied. So it could be e power jk 2 pi by 3t. That is what is written here. Understand this? Okay. Now, the same thing you will do on this side. The minus is already there. Take a bracket. Okay. And do, you will get this. And there is a pi by 3 term and there is a 2 pi by 3 term. So bring pi by 3 term in one place. So it would be minus of minus. So it would, you will get a plus sign here. So this is one pair. Okay. And another pair that you can search for is this. You take minus common and this 2 pi by 3 plus 2 pi by 3 case and the term and the minus 2 pi by 3. So bring this as a pair. Now, how is this looking? Now, what this is in the standard form. Which term, if you have to express this in terms of sinusoidal, where it is written as cos 2 cos pi by 3k, because this term along with 2 in the denominator is cos pi by 3k. Everybody understand? This term along with 2 in the denominator is cos pi by 3k. Since 2 is not there, so it becomes 2 cos pi by 3k. Similarly, minus 2 cos 2 pi by 3k. Understand that? So here this 2 is there, right? This 2 you take out, fine, it would become 1 by 3, and you can just bring this, just you have to, if you have to eliminate this minus means, bring the second term first and first term second, and you have, that is what they have written here. Understand? The detailed steps are kept in next page, okay, for your reference, how this is done. Okay, so it will not be a problem. You can just go through this and you can obtain your x of case. Understand? Now, the next problem. Okay. Again, a waveform is given. You are asked to find out the Fourier series coefficients. Now, again, you have to find out what is the fundamental period and what is the angular frequency. You need not have to do the periodic test. So the given signal has to be a periodic signal. So say this is repetitive. So just by seeing, we can easily understand this is repetitive in nature. From here to here, you can say it is repetitive. From 0 to 2, it is repetitive. So this V pattern V you are seeing. So pattern V is repeating, you can say. Or this pattern, the triangular, what you are seeing is this pattern is repeating. So you can take the what is the fundamental period, after how many seconds the patterns are repeating. So they are repeating after 2 seconds. This is 1 second. This is another second. So 2 seconds is fundamental period. Fine. And you can take the integral limits starting from minus 1 to plus 1, or you can say it is going from 0 to 2, whichever the way. Fine. Now, so fundamental period is 2 seconds. And since it is 2 seconds, your angular frequency would be 5 radians per second. Understand that? So here, one thing that we need to do is, when we are applying the integration x of t, what is x of t here and what is x of t here. The advantage in previous problem was it was like this. So we can, I can say this is 1, this is minus 1, this is 1, this is minus 1. Understand that? Okay, in another problem, they had given this to be sine pi t. They already have given this as sine pi t. Get that point? The signal was already given. Okay, what is the signal for one particular period? That could easily be made out. But here, we need to find out what is this x of t from minus 1 to 0. What is this x of t from 0 to 1? And that is what is done here. And I've not taken that equation for straight line. I've already shown you that in first chapter, how to obtain the equations for this. Okay, take that equation for line and obtain this. So x of t is 1 plus t from minus 1 to 0. And it is 1 minus t from 0 to 1. Understand this? Now, let's write the equation for x of k and bring this x of t in that equation. That is what is done here. Okay. Now, see how x of k, this is the equation for x of k, the analysis equation where we'll be getting the frequency information. Frequency information means coefficients of Fourier series in frequency domain. Fine. Now, substitute x of t. X of t is 1 plus t over minus 1 to 0. The period is, period that you have to take is minus 1 to 1. Okay, this fundamental period or the one period that we are considering is from minus 1 to 1. But from minus 1 to 1, it is not the same signal. There are two different signals. So from minus 1 to 0, there is one signal. From 0 to 1, there is another signal. That's why we have to split one period, that is minus 1 to 1, into two integrals. Understand? So from minus 1 to 1, it is this. From 0 to 1, it is this. And integrate. Okay? So after integrating, we are going to get this is what the textbook says. I just directly took that to show that here. Okay, but the detailed steps are here. I'll come to this step. Before that, let's see what's happening here. So you have to integrate. There are two terms. There are two terms here. One is t term, another one is the exponential term. So if it is that, you first integrate the exponential and keep 1 plus t as it is. So this is what we've done for first step, and this is what we've done for second step. Okay, and you apply the limits of integration. I'm not going to explain term by term here. Anyways, this will be there in when you're going through this. Okay, so you can pause and you can make a notes of this. But yes, you have to help me out where means I'm not able to eliminate this 1 by 2 term, which is missing in the answer that is given in textbook. Okay, so just clarify this. Is this 1 by 2 existing or I've done wrong anywhere? And one more thing that you have to remember is e power j pi k is substituted as 1 and e power minus j pi k is substituted as minus 1 by minus 1 to the power k. So these two substitutions would go here. Okay, just go through that, but I'm getting this 1 by 2 term. Okay, which is not here. This 1 by 2 is there, right? So this 1 by 2 is retained in the last answer. Fine. So which is not shown here. So see which is correct. Is it missing here? I have done some mistake in eliminating that 1 by 2. Okay. Just do that or the detailed steps are here. Fine with it. Now you can go through that. It should not, you should not have any problem in doing that. Fine. So this is what the option. Let's assume that this is correct and let's go on with this. Fine. Now see here, they have asked us to plot the frequency, the magnitude spectrum and phase spectrum. Where in the question, see here, draw the spectra. They have told very clearly. That's why we are going to draw the spectra here. Fine. But understand, in this equation itself, if I go to find out what is it at k equal to 0, see, it's very clearly said this equation holds good for k not equal to 0. Okay, so I cannot find out what is the quotient at k equal to 0 with this equation. Tell me what is the idea? Because if k is equal to 0, this should become infinity. Or here, if k is equal to 0, this would become, and this x of k would become 0. So any equation wherein we are having infinite value, okay, should not be considered for finding out that particular quotient. So let's go one step back. So in this, since this equation is not allowing us to see whether what is x of k at k equal to 0, so go one step back. In this equation, you try apply k equal to 0. If you apply k equal to 0, okay, x of 0 would happen to be 1 by 2. Understand? And see, in this x of k, we don't have j term. Everybody able to make out that? We don't have a j term. If we don't have a j term, it means that the imaginary part is missing. So this is a real part. If real part is there, only magnitude spectra would be there. The phase spectra will not exist, okay, for the equation that we have obtained. Now, so that is what x of k is 1 by 2. Okay, and for even numbers, x of k would be 0. For odd numbers, x of k is 2 by pi square k square. So why is that there? See here, for k equal to 0, so that we have done by this equation, because here this equation is not applicable for k equal to 0. That's why what we have done is, we have obtained x of 0 from this, and what is it for x of 1? So when this is x of 1, what happens? This is 1 means what happened? This would be minus 1 only, so it would be 1 plus 1, so it would be 2 by pi square by k square when this k is 1. When this k is 2, what happens? When this k is 2, this would become plus 1. Minus 1 would become plus 1 because minus 1 squared. So when it is minus 1 squared, it would become 1, so it would be 1 minus 1, so x of k would be 0. So what's happening is, for all odd numbers of k, for all odd numbers of k, this would be minus 1, minus of minus 1 would become 2. So this term would be 2 for all odd values of k, and this term would be 0 for all even values of k. So that is why we have written this. Okay, and see, the j term is missing. That's why we'll have only the magnitude spectrum. Is that okay with you? Fine. So it's 2 by pi square k square. Just for 1, it is 2 by pi square. For 3, it is 2 by pi square 3 square. That is this. Okay, so it will go on decreasing. Again, what is that we need to be seeing here? This is an even signal. We have seen the magnitude spectra is always a even signal, we can say. And phase spectrum is null spectrum. They call it as null spectrum because all elements are zero there, because the given signal x of t is real and even. So this happens because x of t is real and even. Understand? Okay, so let's go on with the next problem. So this is important. Now, problems to find x of t. Till now we were finding out x of k. Now this is finding out x of t. We cannot in strict sense say that we are going with the techniques to find out x of t as we did in z transform. We used the partial fraction method, we used power series expansion method or long division method, which it is called as. Such techniques are not there. You know, we simply use the equation for x of t and we find out. Okay, so this is the equation we use to find out x of t. Now see here, this is the x of k given. Since we are asked to find out x of t, x of k is given. Now seeing the x of k, okay, so we should find out x of t. So x of t, this is the synthesis equation. Fine. So before going there, we shall understand this particular x of k. What is this x of k? This x of k says it is j into delta of k minus. What is delta of k minus 1? delta, where do you think delta of k minus 1 exists, and what is this? This delta of k minus 1 exists at k equal to 1. This exists at k equal to minus 1. This delta of k minus 3 exists at k equal to 3. This delta of k plus 3 exists at k equal to minus 3. And they have given omega naught is pi. So let's bring this x of k in this place. Okay. That is this. Fine. Substituting omega naught equal to pi. Okay. So omega naught is substituted as pi here. And in place of x of k, we have brought the given x of k here with this omega naught substituted as pi. Now what happens? So this summation and this exponential has to be associated with every term here. So how many such terms are there? There are four such terms, and with every term among these four terms, okay, this summation and this exponential should come. So how can you evaluate this summation if it is that? This is the question. Now how does that look like now? See, yeah, they say this is how it is going to look like. How is that? How is that? It says j into delta of k minus 1 into this. So you can keep j outside the summation, and you can just deal with this delta and this. And which property? The shifting property comes into picture now. Shifting property says if this is x, if so, yeah, this is delta and this is x of t. What happens with x of k if it is delta of k minus 1? This exponential has to be evaluated at k equal to 1. So if it is evaluated at k equal to 1, k would vanish, only j into e power j pi t will remain. Similarly here, it is evaluated at k equal to 1. But if you take this exponential along with these two, k will have a value plus 3 ones, and k will have a value minus 3 ones. Okay, here it is k equal to 1, here it is k equal to minus 1, here it is k equal to plus 3, here it is k equal to minus 3. That part is missing there. Okay, maybe we shall do it properly. Yeah, now I think this should be visible. Yeah, get that? So this is how it is being made. Fine, e bar jk pi t is there. Just keep on associating this with this signal, and shifting property, we know from shifting property it becomes this. So this and this along with the summation is being applied to all the four terms, and this is being associated with this exponential. Now this exponential, if it is there with this delta of k minus, this delta of k minus 1 is existing at k equal to 1. That's why this has to be evaluated at k equal to 1. So it becomes e power j pi t. So this becomes, if when it this gets along with this summation, this has to be evaluated at t equal to minus 1. So it becomes this. So when it gets associated with this, this has to be evaluated at k equal to 3. When it is associated with this, it has to be evaluated at k equal to minus e. That is what is done here. So this is your x of t. Everyone understand? Simple problems. Okay. Now, the next problem. In the next problem, what's happening? Okay. X of k is given, but here k, this signal is in which form? It is in compact form. Okay, we have to expand this in a proper way. What is the meaning of this magnitude k? This implies that this x of k exists from minus infinity to plus infinity is what is the meaning of this k. So attach all negative values once and attach all positive values once. Okay, so omega naught is one, they have told. Fine. So x of t we can find out by this equation. Magnitude k implies that x of k exists for all k's. So x of t can be x of k rather. This is not x of t. This is a mistake. This is not x of t. This is x of k, mind you. Okay. This x of k. Fine. So this x of k has to be enough expanded like this. This is, mind you, I'm telling again and again, this is x of, this is not x of t, this is x of k. Fine. See, k takes a value minus k, and when it takes the value minus k, k ranges from minus 1, minus infinity to minus 1. It takes a value plus k, and the limits of summation is going from 0 to infinity. So what is it? What are we covering? We are covering from minus infinity to plus infinity. Everybody understand that? So x of k, this is x of k only. Or no, so see here, this is x of t only. What they have done is they have directly gone for substitution. Very sorry from my side. Okay, see, this is x of t only. What they have done is they directly have substituted this stuff. This signal is taken from minus infinity to minus 1. Once from minus infinity to minus 1, what is x of k? X of k is minus k here. Okay, along with this exponential where this omega naught is 1. Okay, this is x of t only. They have done it directly. I say it again. Okay, I'm sorry, this is not x of k, this is x of t only. So what they have done, so they have not gone for expanding it. They could have gone for expanding this first before substitution, but they have not done that. They have directly gone for substitution, so you should be able to make out that. Fine. So it's k ranging from minus infinity to minus 1 first, because this says that you have to have all negative and positive. Let's have negative values first. So minus infinity to minus 1, when we have this k, would have minus value minus k. Understand? And this omega naught is 1. You don't attach minus to this exponential, but you have to attach minus to the case we have in x of k here. So we have attached it only here. Understand? Now next set is, this k will take the values ranging from 0 to infinity, and from 0 to infinity, this k values will have positive k. Understand? So now evaluate this. So just take this, because there is a k common in both the powers. So bring this exponential and this term along with each other, okay, with the common power. So here also this half and e are taken together, okay, and k is taken out. Now observe this. This is a standard summation which we know. It is going from 0 to infinity. So if you consider this as a, so it's summation k ranging from 0 to infinity a par k, or you can say it is n ranging from 0 to infinity a par n, whichever the way. So what is it? So that is shown here. See here. If you have k equal to 0 to infinity, it is 1 by 1 minus a, this summation. See here. Here k is ranging from 0 to infinity, right? So if this is a, this is 1 by 1 minus a. So there is a negative sign with this. So it is 1 by 1 minus of minus this would become. So second term. What's happening with the first term? It's not starting at 0. It's starting at 1. So you should understand this. If it's starting at 1, okay, so it's a power 1 divided by 1 minus. If it is starting at 0, it is a power 0 divided by 1 minus a. Okay, simple stuff. Just once again, this is something that we know. Okay, how can we read this? This is, there is 1, right? So this 1 means it is a to the power 0. This is a to the power 0. So this is a to the power 0 means this is supposed to be a to the power 1. Understand? So that's why in the first term, this is this signal, this term to the power 1 divided by 1 minus minus of this. Okay, this is 1. So that is what is written here. So take the LCM. Okay, so you cannot multiply. This is not the same term. Mind you, there is a minus here, there is a plus here. So take the LCM and you would see that you would find your x of t to be this. Everybody is okay with this? Okay, so this is what I had to give you. Fine, we have found out x of k's and we have found out x of t's also given the coefficients. So this is what I had to cover regarding Fourier series. So Fourier series is quite a small topic in your syllabus, because it comes along with the properties, okay, properties of system. So that part I still have not taken. So this is module 3 part 2. So module 3 part 2 is over by this. Okay, there are some more problems which we can take up. Okay, but you should be able to solve anything with whatever we have solved so far. Understand this? So with that, I think we can end this session. Okay.